Hello everyone, and welcome back to my Realism Overhaul series in Kerbal Space Program 0.23. In the previous episode, we launched Alice to the Moon, and it was a successful flyby mission with plenty of science done. Lots and lots of science done, in fact. But I have to say that we probably can't go too much farther than this with this launcher. And too much farther than this really means how much did we actually launch to the moon. When we talk about empty mass, it's empty. 0.3 tons. Now, that means that if I wanted to slap a heat shield on here, let's find out the heat shield. Let's say we even use the minimal heat shield. No, there's no way that could work. I think there's a 1 meter heat shield somewhere. Okay, let's just pretend. I know this wouldn't work, but no, even that wouldn't be enough. So it would have to be one of the 1.25 meter heat shields, and that's 0.46. So the mass of the heat shield is greater than the empty mass of the probe itself. So the whole thing will be more than double the mass. And if you've got more than double the mass, there's no way this would be able to get to the moon. So we need a new launcher. And yeah, that's basically the project for today. My goal is to make this stage, currently the RL-10 stage, this guy. This should be the third stage. This should be the lunar transit stage. And the reason I want it as the lunar transit stage is pretty simple. The RL-10A3 has an ISP of 444 in the vacuum. Now, I don't think I can get too much better than that. It's also got a decent thrust to weight ratio. Its mass is only 0.17. Its max thrust is 66, which is, it's not great, but it's good for a transit stage like this. So we pretty much want to preserve this stage, though it probably can't be so big. We really only need it to throw us to the moon. As long as we can get to the moon, we're fine. Why don't we reconfigure this probe a bit? Now, if we want a heat shield, let's just get the heat shield on and just start with things like that. So let's say we've got a heat shield. Now, what can we do with this? Well, I guess the logical thing is to replace, instead of having, thrusters, we need the RCS, right? So we'll have to do the old configuration where I put RCS. Now, here's the thing. I think it's time to upgrade our telecommunication system, and well, that's pretty heavy, 0.5. But you know, the great thing about this one is it doesn't say that it snaps under high pressure. See, this one snaps under high dynamic pressure. This one is fine apparently under high dynamic pressure, at least I hope so. We'll have to test that. But it's a 0.5 tons. Can we do it? I think we have to try. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna try and launch something fairly heavy at the moon. And that's what our launcher is going to have to be able to handle. Oh, I discovered something. We don't really... and actually this is probably not one of the service... Is it one of the service tanks? Let me see. Because we need to be... Oh, it is. It's got hydrazine. Alright. So let's remove these nitric acid and amine tanks, and let's go with hydrazine, but we don't need 500 hydrazine. We really only need hydrazine to make sure that our course on the way back is, or I guess we have need enough to leave the moon, maybe. We'll see. It depends on whether we it depends on exactly how we do the mission. There are a few types of configurations. This is obviously gonna be heavy thing, so we'll be lucky to get it back. Oh, I don't know if the heat shield will cover the top dish properly. It's already pretty heavy. Which is a... Well, it's not too much heavier, actually. Let's see. I guess I'll feel more comfortable with that. And it's only a bit heavier, it's like 0.3 tons heavier. We're really making this heavy, aren't we? Well, let's reduce the size of the fuel tank. It's a little bit better. We've now got this big dish up top, so we really don't need this one. I put this one off to the side because we do need this one. But let's put it, let's put it here. Oh, and one thing I discovered about this sort of tank is that we can pack electric charge into it. Electric charge does take mass, so if we add electric charge, you can see the mass goes up. But it's in proportion to how much. Let's say we just put 7,500. Don't want to get into five digits. So, anyway, so it's in proportion to the other sorts of batteries that we see in Realism Overhaul, which are pretty big. They're all pretty big. Let's say this should be 360. It's a good round number. Okay. All right. That looks good. Won't resize the tank in actual size. We've got some thermometers. I don't want the I want on the science down here actually now. Let's for the sake of symmetry, just put four thermometers like this. This antenna, we just need one. And let's sort of poke it like that. Alright, what we really need is more solar panels, but before we do that, I need to figure out where to put the RCS. So I think I'm pretty solid in using these. I guess that's fine. The solar panels are sort of in the way. Let's take off that set. Or maybe I should do it this way. Which way would be better? I think this way would actually preserve the symmetry better. Let's see. Let's get more solar panels. We need a lot of solar panels. And we need parachutes. Oh my god. Oh dear. Okay. Well, I guess we're gonna go with these real chutes. I think... Well... This should get tucked in... Well, let's say here. This... Ooh. Are these panels not on... No, they are on angle snap, so I don't know. I don't understand how the symmetry is working right now. Okay, so we've got to put some parachutes, and I think... two will be right. Ooh. Okay, two on the other sides. Yeah. Okay, hopefully that'll work out safely. And I want more solar panels, because we've got a very powerful dish now. Let's see if that clips the... Ooh. Oh, that might count as some sort of dynamic pressure. So let's put it where it's not going to have that problem. Let's put it here, actually. Okay, and see, now we're supposed to be designing a launch system, and here I am messing with the probe the whole time. These are the problems we have. But we need a robust probe if we're going to bring it back. No point trying to spend money on a huge launch system if you don't have a decent payload, right? Okay, well, that thruster looks like it's got to be hitting the solar panel. I guess that's unsightly. No, we still got Mechjib to deal with. Mechjib's sort of big, isn't it? Not very easy to find a place for Mechjib. We can't get rid of the... Can't really get rid of the solar panels here, I don't think. Not if we want to stay charged up. I could get rid of a pair of thermometers, though. Why does it do this, by the way? I'm sure the new version of Stretchy Tanks fixes that glitch. I hope so. We only need one mech jeb. There can be only one mech jeb. Oh no, I did it too many times. Okay, that's sufficient. And it looks like our probe is 1.5 tons, which is heavy. Heavy, heavy, heavy. But let's see. One thing I can do now is... Hold on. Let's snap that there. Let's get rid of this whole thing where I was messing around with the side fairings. We don't need the side fairings anymore. We've now got the right parts. We've got the fairing base ring 2 meter. Yes. Not fairing. We want the... custom fairing? No, I guess they're both alright. Anyway, 2 meter. Yes. So now we can have proper fairings that we can throw off at the right altitude instead of trying to hang on to them and peek into the fairings and all that. No more of that sort of thing. Let's get it all nice and tight. This can go away. Okay, and so... symmetry does not like that. Okay, alright. Well, we got on anyway. So, where the heck does this get 5,000? Oh, it's that much. Wow, okay. That's a pretty big stage, isn't it? Let's not have such a big stage. What I want is just enough to get us to the moon. Well, that's a lot. Actually, I think 3,300 would be sufficient. Yeah, that should be more than enough to get us to the moon. Is this all right? I don't know. Let's see. Sea level thrust looks actually pretty high for this day. Well, I guess it would be. It doesn't matter, as we're not going to be burning at a sea level. It's actually going to have a thrust weight ratio of 1, which is... Wow, okay. I wasn't expecting that. Anyway, let's refuel this properly. I think I want to pack enough lighter for 3 lights altogether. So let's have that. There's no point not to have more though. Well, I'll just add extra mass, so... Every little bit counts around here. Especially since we have such a heavy payload. Okay, that looks fine. I guess we'll fill up the rest with that. Yeah. Alright, let's keep that as is. Now, we have to be careful about these. This set of boosters, these are actually for knowledge, and I'm just gonna put them on top for now. These are the fairings, that's fine. That looks fine. Actually, maybe we can boost its radius a little bit more. Can we? I'm trying to boost its radius. Ah, there we go. That looks better. Now, the rest of this we can dump. When you look at the stats... So, this is the engine we have as our third stage now. But we wouldn't be able to use this one. This was our first stage engine. There's no way we can use it as our second stage. If you take a look at the engine ISP, it's 290, which is horrible. Its max thrust is overpowered for a second stage. And it's just not efficient for that purpose. So we need a different second stage engine. Gimbal... Yeah, I mean, that's really all that matters right now. So this is not a good second stage. So let's try and find a good second stage. What we need is something with low engine ISP at... So this is a good second stage, but it's too big. Whoa, we don't need that big. And it's even bigger than the previous one, this LR89, in terms of thrust. So we don't need something with more thrust. That has less thrust, good stats, but I don't think it's enough of a gap between this. This is another RL-10. between this and this. There's not enough of a gap. We need at least four times this one's thrust, I think. Nothing less than that. That's a launch stage. Too weak. No. This is obviously a launch stage. The good one. The core and boosters of the Delta IV rocket. Okay, so none of those. This is a launch stage. Oh, this could do. Let's bring this out. That's another J2. Too overpowered for this rocket. That's useless. Useless. Launch stages. Oh, I guess we could take a look at the radial. Nope, that's more of a launch. That's a lower stage anyway. Okay, so I guess we're down to just one choice. The RD-0124. Well, that's a famous rocket. Upper stage engine for the Soyuz 2, burning kerosene and LOX. So, let me get this smaller here. Let's design the fairings now. What I need is, how big is this thing? What sort of tanks do we need for it? Well, you know, we should at least go to 3 meters, I think. Even going 2.5 just wouldn't look right. I guess this is a 2.5 meter one, right? Yeah, it's 2.5. But then, well, I guess before I do anything else, let's just put this as a holding tank and take a look at the launch stages. This is not a launch stage. A launch stage is one that has a high sea level ISP. So these are all low sea level ISP. This is a high sea level ISP. Okay. But that's way too... well, no, it's not too... well, it is a bit too much. Anyway, let's see what else we've got. If we don't have anything else... Wait. Oh yeah, this one was... I mean, I knew I had a... This is the LR-89. I knew I had a pair of LR-87s like this. And let's take a look. The stats on... well, this is much smaller, isn't it? This has a max thrust of 3,552. This one has just 2,387. But its thrust-to-weight ratio is very nice. Its mass is only 2.3. This one has a mass of 9.9. This one has the better ISP, so that's an advantage. But I don't think I need all that power. Well, let's bring this down. Ooh, it's smaller too. Yeah, I don't like this is crazy. This is crazy big. Let's hang on to this. And it's a good way to go because this is the LR-89, and so this was the using the first stage of the Titan III, I think that's an appropriate thing to step up to. But this one, yeah, this is a little bit less powered. It's even smaller. It'll definitely fit under a 2.5 meter stage. How's its ISP compare? It has better ISP, this one. But I don't think it could lift the rest of this. We'll see. I think those are the only two candidates. So these are the only two candidates for this stage. Let's try with the weaker engine first. But let's configure the stages so that this one will fit. So I think we'll need a 3 meter part. I don't want to have two tapers, if you will. No, 3 meter. Okay, so we're gonna assume a 3 meter part. No. I don't think we have 3 meters, but we don't need that anyway. It is an inner stage fairing. So we'll, this one, yeah. Snap that on there. Right, and, oh, come on, get rid of that. No, no more. All right. Conic fairings. Ooh, lots of attachment points. Really? Let's go all the way to back here. Alright. Which way was it? This way. There's the J key. And then the Y key for width. And I don't think we need that much height, actually. Let me just make sure. Yeah. Okay. So that's that part. Let's stick this guy over here. And we need another one of these. Same deal. Three-meter tank. Well, let's get everything done here first. N. Then there. There. And side fairings. Okay. Go. Okay. I think that looks fine. So we're gonna try with this one first. This is all messed up. Let's get this engine down here. Those will fall off. And that's the decoupler there. Let's make sure that's alright. Nope, that's not alright. This is the engine there. Kerbal is very creative when it comes to... Oh, those fairings are very high. Well, let me bring those back down. We don't want the fairings to be larger than they need to be, because... Aha. Okay, just for my amusement, let me pick a texture. I guess we'll go with these. Okay. Right. Need to fill up the tanks. So, oh, wait. It's still all messed up, isn't it? Alright, that finally looks to be right. And we've got the right delta V there. Let me take a look here. We need the delta V for the RD0124. And then finally, I guess is the RD253. Okay, RD253, what was that used on? The Proton rocket. Well, not exactly the most illustrious rocket ever, but... So let's get this to sea level thrust to weight ratio of 1.2 to look at it. So what we need is the first stage and the second stage to take care of 9,500 meters per second of delta V. Right now we've got 8,500. Gonna stretch this one out. I guess maybe around 7 minutes of burn time, vacuum time. Well, that's getting the base stage very iffy, isn't it? Let's just say 7 minutes flat. Now we've got 9,200, tantalizing close, but if we take a look at the sea level thrust, it's too low. If we get it back down, we seem to be able to get about 8,900 out of this. I don't think this is going to be enough. I don't think there's any way I can size these two tanks to give us 9,500, so I'm just gonna dump this. I like the idea of using the Titan III's engines anyway. Okay, but we're gonna have to dump the fuel in this tank. And there was a little bit of slack volume here, but it wouldn't have made that much of a difference. Every additional bit of fuel you add has diminishing returns. Aerozine and N204, if I remember correctly, the LR-87 can run under many different types of fuel, and so there's just one fuel configuration. It happens to be a hypergolic fuel configuration, and that's pretty rare for a first stage, as it says there. Now, where did my engine actually end up in terms of staging? Wow, that... very, very confusing. Alright, okay, so there's top fairings right there. Okay, well, it looks like we have more sea level thrust now. So let's make use of that. 0.7. Still not enough, though. Let me get this to 8 minutes flat. Let me shrink this one. Now that's 9,100. 9,200. That's not very good. I think we need to dump mass on the top, really. Maybe we can tighten up this stage just a little bit. Right now we have no choice, right? This is it. This is the only suitable engine we've got right now. So let's say we reduce the amount of hydrazine we have up here. How much can that give us? Not much. I'd rather have the hydrazine, honestly. I know the electric charge isn't producing too much mass there. It's really the heat shield and the antenna, but we're gonna have the 0.5 mass antenna is rough. But it's the one that can guarantee communication in the atmosphere so I can pop the parachutes. So that's a thing. I really want to guarantee my ability to communicate with this. But for the first one, for the first trial, maybe I'll relent and dump that and go with this one. I don't want this on top though, really. So why don't I place a solar panel on top and place one of these on the side. Okay, so we're gonna go with this version and hopefully we'll be able to communicate with it. A little bit smaller. Let's reduce the size of this stage. I mean, I guess we could relight this stage. Why don't we do that instead? Let's go with the relight version. This one has a lot of thrust. Let me try that with the other antenna instead of having this one. Let's see if we can get everything we want onto this. So, we're going to rely more on this stage. Let's say we extend it to... No, come on. Okay, well, some sort of weird fuel thing just happened, I think. Yeah, I think it's definitely not full of fuel right now. Come on. Let me just remove all tanks. Say 3.6 will give me an extra relight. I want that. As I resize, I might lose that relight. Okay, and the rest like that. Ah, there we go. That's much better. Okay. 5 minutes and 30 seconds there. So we're no longer going to rely on these two to get us into orbit. We'll have to light this one for a little bit in order to make orbit. I guess that's fine. Let's reduce the size of this second stage, which is pretty weak right now. So I estimate we've got about 800, let's say, in this top stage. So what we're really looking for from this these bomb two is 8,700. This goes for 7 minutes and 5 seconds. Let's make this one bigger. Not that much bigger. This will take some optimization, obviously. I think that's enough buffer. I think that'll do nicely. Control's gonna be a bit of an issue though. We do have gimbling on this. But I'm a little bit worried about the aerodynamics of such a large rocket. I guess we could afford little winglets. Let me just a little bit. Eh, couldn't hurt. And wait. We've got a mess here. Okay, those are those. Those are the top fairings. Why does it always do that to me? Okay. Now we're looking good. You know, maybe we could launch with, maybe we could get this bomb stage Maybe we can get the first and second stages to 9,500 if we put some SRBs on. I don't like SRBs as a rule, but I'm gonna add them. Let's make sure we add them with radial decouplers. And let's see, what about these big ones? These big ones look good. Do they add anything at all? I think they actually reduced the amount of delta V I have. But that might be because of their burn time. Hold on, let me do some thrust limiting here. Okay, oh wait, they're detaching at the same time as the rest of the stack. That's not right. Okay, well that gives us a little bit more juice, but not that much actually. I don't know if it's for a marginal improvement, it might be okay, but I don't think they're really constructive in this case. Wait, I said 1,700. This is pretty close actually, isn't it? This is actually under that, so I need to boost up this stage. Ooh. Let me boost this stage. Let me get... I really don't like my choices here. Oh, this one's a little bit too low right now. Well, I'll have to... Let me go to 2 minutes and 30 seconds on this one. That's really low on the sea level thrust, though. Worse than before. Maybe the only thing to do is to slap some... Well, actually, I can do some marginal improvement. I can take a peek in here. Oh no, that's not what I wanted to do. Come on. Take a peek in here and reduce... Sorry about that. Reduce the hydrazine to, let's say, that. Now everything looks good. Okay, I think I've done enough of this sort of tinkering. Let's try and launch it. Okay, this isn't Alice anymore. I've decided on... So it is a launcher test, so we gotta name it... name the launcher. And the launcher I've decided on is Forseti, which is the Norse god of justice. Yes. Anyway, I just picked the name because it sounded okay. Forseti sounds like a good launcher name. Okay, so this bound to be a lot of things that could go wrong with this. This is just a launcher test. Let's save it and let's try it out. Now obviously the main thing that can go wrong is that our launch trajectory won't be very good. We've got to burn through this stage, burn through this stage, and burn part of this stage in order to get into orbit, and we might just not have enough time. In which case maybe I need more of an oomph. Maybe I do need to add the solid rocket boosters. So that's what we're checking. This launch is really to check whether we need solid rocket boosters. And I'm not looking to get to the moon this time just yet. I want to see how much that everything else works out. So I will set the moon as a target though. And... You know, we're not too far off. It's just a test, so I'm going to look to see... I'm actually impressed that we get the ascending and descending node here. I didn't think we would. I thought, well, I guess we do. All right. We're a little bit off, though. We're a lot off. Anyway, what I'm going to do is not go to the moon. What I'm going to do is I'm going to set it to a 23.5 degree inclination, and at least that'll be an accurate test. We're not going to the moon this time. We'll just... I want to test re-entry too, so we will bring it back down. That's one thing I want to do, okay? If everything else works. Alright, so here we go with the test of the launcher for SETI. About 166 tons, still pretty light compared to other launch systems during the late 50s. I mean, if you take a look at what the Russians were putting up with the R7 style rockets, those are pretty darn heavy. Those are more than twice as heavy as this, or around twice as heavy as this. Yeah, don't quote me on that. I don't know. All I know is they were way overpowered. That I know. Okay, let's give it a little bit of lean in. So I'm gonna go north 23.5 degrees. We would be going up. So that means, what is it? 66.5 degrees? Okay, it is closer than I want to be. Okay, we're control is not great, honestly. But at least it's not too wobbly. Good old Kerbal joint reinforcement. I might need to tweak the gibbling on this to give it more. I think Yeah, gimbling is just at 1 degree. Right, I'm not gonna change that right now though. But I've got to tweak a little gimbal on this so that we can change that. So yeah, whenever I build my rockets, unless I manually tweak the gimbling, it'll give me a gimbling of just 1 degree instead of whatever the rocket spec says. And that's good because SAS seems to have a little bit of trouble with the extra degrees of, I wouldn't say degrees of freedom, but the extra degrees that it can make use of. Now, an interesting thing is this launcher doesn't produce very sharp g-forces. Thanks to the fact that it is a three-stage rocket, it doesn't feature very high g-forces at any stage, I don't think. Actually, let's see what the peak is. Let's see stats. See it all. Well, the base stage gets up to 4.7. We could fix that. We could just, if we did decide to put solid rocket boosters on, we could actually make the first stage heavy. Well, no, actually, we could do all sorts of stuff. We could extend the second stage is what we really could do. Anyway. I really need to be more like 25 degrees right now. Okay, first stage separation is good. Well, you never know when those sorts of things might have an issue. And the lighting of the second stage, we didn't need any special igniter. It's got its own hypergolic fluid, so. I think I probably need to tilt up a little bit more here. I think I can dump the fairing here. Excellent. Okay, that's fairing separation. Might be the first in this series that I get to do that. All nice and good. Let's have this one target G-stat. G-stat. And I guess we can activate here. And I want my... Oh, I should have hotkeyed the... The ever okay antenna here, the commutatron. Let's get that out. Well, everything's looking good so far. Just looking at how much time to apoapsis versus the stage time though, and that's a little bit worrying. I guess I'll aim for an apoapsis of about 200k this time. That would be an appropriate altitude to make a lunar transfer. If we're 300k like I was doing with some of the other rockets, I think that's a little bit too high. It doesn't take advantage of the Oberth effect and all that, so... Well, not doesn't take advantage of, takes less advantage of, let's put it that way. Ooh, another thing I need to check out is whether I've got enough solar panels to recharge this while this main dish is on. I mean, it's only got a draw of 0.08 charge, but of course on our Alice mission, we had electric charge issues, so I've got to keep that in mind. And of course, going 23.5 degrees north means that we don't get quite as much boost from the rotation of the planet. It looks like it's not too far off. Yeah. It's not too far off, though. not too big a deal. Important to note that for future reference, if we want to send this into a normal equatorial orbit, perhaps with a geostationary satellite or something like that. Well, looks like we're gonna pass 200. Not much I can do about that. Okay, here we go, second stage separation, and we're good. We are on the third stage. Very nice. Okay, 223 by 209. 224 by 210, actually. Not bad for the first time with this particular launch system. Not bad at all. And actually, the thing I'm most irritated by is the fact that I didn't get to the right inclination, but, you know, could be worse. Could definitely be worse. We've had much more trouble with launch systems before. So now, what I want to do is have it hang out here for a little bit. Actually, all I want to do is get the fuel flow to be unstable, and then we're going to try and use the Ullage rockets to relight it. And once I've checked that the relighting works out just fine, we'll bring it back down. So let's wait until... Okay, we're unstable now. Let's get very unstable. Very, very, very unstable. Let's wait till this is negative 100 or more. I think that's fine. Okay, and let's try and relight now. Let me just go prograde. We've just got the tiny reaction wheel at the top of the probe right now. Actually, we could use the RCS, but I might as well try and use that for deorbiting. Just to see how much juice we've got with that 252 units. Okay, so... yep, let's try and... Okay, very good. Relight was successful. So that's fine. We don't need to keep that going. You know, actually, maybe we should try re-entering from a very high orbit. Just to see whether... No, that's not really necessary. The key thing is whether this dish remains functional. Let's try and hit hitting mission control wouldn't be a very good test. If we tried to deorbit and hit mission control, it wouldn't be a very good test of the antenna system because the reflectron, the one that's always open, the one that has short range, that one will be able to communicate with mission control then. So I want to have this big reflectron connect to GSTAT. Let me quickly switch to GSTAT to tell it to do that. Okay, here we are with our geosynchronous satellite, and what we need to do is switch from unknown target, which was our previous mission, to the Forseti. Okay, so now that's all taken care of. Let's go back to the Forseti. Okay, here we are, and let's see where... let's actually go into go around so that we're on the bright side again. I don't want to... we need to check electric charge. Okay, that's an issue. Where are we angled? Oh, we're basically not pointing at the sun at all. Let me use RCS to adjust this. Let me turn to north, so that we can catch some sunlight here. Let's see if that will help us recharge. It's not quite enough though. So that could do with some redesign. Okay. You know what? We can dump this. Well, let's make sure that this stage deorbits as well. I guess we don't want to leave the space junk. So So let's carry it along, and we'll have it do the orbit burn then. Okay, we're in daylight now. We definitely have enough fuel for the moon. As you can see, 3400 delta V here would be enough for the moon transfer without any problems. This is a little bit of a problem. Oh no, this doesn't come off a decoupler. Aha, I have found a problem. this can't decouple right now. Oh dear, we've got a serious issue here. Huh. So we can't really test out the heat shield or everything. This is gonna be in trouble. Okay, yeah, so let me just deorbit this. This is not gonna survive. Yeah. Well, maybe. I could envision a scenario where this might work out. So let's give it a go. I can see the scenario involves these parts blowing up, but then the heat shield being revealed. Yeah, I guess that's possible. But we need the college rocket, and let's check stability. Very unstable. Okay. Well, that will definitely bring us in and probably blow some stuff up. Let's see. Oh, shoot. I accidentally pressed spacebar. How do I accidentally press spacebar after playing this game for so long? Ah, well, there goes that theory. Well, here's a little probe. Hello. You know what? We might... No, I think we've already done... We've done gravioli over the water. I was going like, maybe we can get some science out of this. Probably not. This is all going to... Well, in this series so far, I've shown you when everything gets destroyed, so let's just do this. Ah, silly. Why did I press spacebar? I think I was actually reaching for time warp, but I'm not too sure. Just some sort of subconscious thing. But yeah. So I'll end the episode by going to VAB and adding that decoupler in. And we'll have to see whether that makes a big difference in terms of the mass and what delta V we have left. Well, at least everything gets returned into the atmosphere. That thing is tumbling around. All over the place. Wow, that's pretty random, isn't it? Okay, all snuffed out. Alright, so yes, let's go to VAB and add that little bit in. Okay, so note for the future, we really do need to have a decoupler here, because while these act as decouplers, though ejection force zero is not very great, some of these do and some of these don't. This one is, it has an ejector. This one has decouplers. These fairing ring bases, and I use this one, don't have. Okay, but so future reference. But now I need a decoupler that isn't too heavy. I mean, that's not bad. Is this 2 meters or 1.25? Well, that doesn't look too bad anyway. Let's see if we've got a 2 meter one. 1 meter one. I could deal with this. Wait. There. I mean, hopefully it'll balance and, you know, it'll be alright. Let's make sure staging is good, which it isn't. But, I mean, staging is not good at all. Alright, and then let's get fairings back on. And in their own thing. And we're ready to go for another try at this, and next time I'll aim for the moon. I think the launch system worked fairly well. I don't think the additional mass that we just added with this decoupler, 0.026, is going to make a big difference. Of course, I'm undersizing the decoupler, and maybe that'll cause balance issues, maybe not. We'll see. I should probably just go for the decoupler that is the right size, but that's a lot of extra mass. So I'm going to avoid that. Our margins are pretty tight this time. When you look at how much delta V we used, it was pretty tight. But we have a launch system that can get a probe to the moon on its three stages. So that is a thing now. Alright, on that note, thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please do press like. If you have any comments or suggestions, leave them in the comment section below, and I'll see you next time.